So I think the Los Angeles Rams drafting Tutu Atwell with their first pick, which was in the second round, to me, this is a win now move, which I know that might sound a little bit surprising, a little bit confusing, because how is it a win now move? But let me elaborate. So when I first, thought of this pick, my first thought is, okay, he runs a 4-3-2. I also know that the Rams went out and they got DeSean Jackson. Is there something that they see in the offense that they want a deep threat? They want something with speed. And kind of, but I actually think going back and watching his tape, to me, what I think they value in him more than anything is just how well he fits their offense. I think they want a guy who they know they can just plug and play and he can be a good receiver for them. I don't think they're as concerned about, how high his ceiling is. They wanted to draft a guy who they just knew could fit their offense and could fit their offense very well and isn't going to be any kind of risk. Like, for example, I probably would have rather them drafted someone like Dyami Brown and just sort of put him in the offense and just assume that he could figure it out. But they kind of did the opposite, and they said, you know what, let's not try and teach a guy a new offense. Let's just get a guy that we know can run it. And so let me show you what I'm talking about. So like right here, perfect example, where it's going to be sort of this jet sweep motion that the Rams love to do. And there's a defender who's unblocked at the line, so Atwell has to make sure he gets past that defender, but watch how he can do it. As you see, he has the speed to run past him, so not just that, but he breaks another tackle as well. So there you go. That's a perfect example of what he can bring to the Rams offense. It's something the Rams do, and that's how his speed plays a role, is being able to run by like that. And honestly, that's something that DeSean Jackson can do as well. So that's kind of why they added both those guys, I think. You also have something like this. And in fact, it's worth mentioning, I just want to watch some of his highlights, because I already evaluated him as a player, but then I went back to sort of see, okay, what am I missing? And I started off with just watching his highlights. That last play was the first one on his highlights. This play is the second one on his highlights. And this is another perfect example of what the Rams do, where it's going to be a play action to the quarterback's left. He then rolls out to his right. Atwell is going to be in motion, and then you throw it to Atwell. And again, watch this. Atwell does a very good job of having the speed to run over, and he picks up as many yards as possible. So that's just a huge, I think, plus for this pick, is just McVay knows Atwell can do the stuff that he wants a receiver to do. And while there's other guys that probably could do that, there's a chance they couldn't. And I think McVay wants to take that risk factor out when you're trying to win a Super Bowl this year. Don't worry about, highest ceiling. Worry about who is going to be good in your offense. Like, even when we talk about a play like this, when we're talking about his speed, usually when he wins deep, it's not even with his speed, quite frankly. Usually it's with like route running and footwork. And this is an example of that, where you see I've circled him on the screen. Watch how he's going to run his route. As you see, he starts off slow. He then kind of cuts back and forth and then runs deep. And then he has the speed at that point where he can run by. But again, it's a lot of with route running, it's more with footwork. That's how he wins deep. It's not even with just pure speed. So kind of just goes to show, clearly that's not why they're drafting him, his ability to run go routes, because he didn't really run go routes. We'll now go over to this play. Let's talk about his route running for a second. So this is going to be just a pick play. And you have the number one receiver run out, try and get into the way of the Miami defender in charge of covering Atwell. And Atwell is going to run towards the sideline, try and get open. And really what's going to be key about this route from Atwell is not just trying to get open, but it's really going to be how he kind of sells as though he could be doing multiple things before he cuts towards the bottom of the screen. Watch him, I think, do a very good job of selling that he could go anywhere and then cutting very quickly on a dime and getting into the end zone for a touchdown. I think that's something that the Rams could value, and it makes sense because I think most teams would value that, quite frankly. That's a good trait to have in a wide receiver. And one more play. So on this one, it's, for one thing, fourth down and five, so key play. But anyways, you see the route he's running. It's against man coverage. He's running over the middle. And the corner who's going up against him is playing very far off Atwell, which could, on one hand, just be like, okay, he's playing that far off because he's afraid of Atwell's speed. I think he's more so just defending the first down marker. But because of this, it's going to work out pretty well for Atwell. He's running over the middle, and since it's a cover one blitz that the defense is in, no one's going to be over the middle, so Atwell can get over. So all of this stuff, kind of just a win before the play is even snapped, given the situation Atwell is in. But anyways, watch out right when this play starts. So Atwell cuts over the middle. He's going to make the catch. He's going to get the first down. All of that stuff, not really that impressive, if we're being honest. It's kind of just the situation he was kind of luckily got put in. But that's not really the important thing for me. The important thing is going to be, can he get to the edge? How many yards can he get out of this? You know, it's less about what did you do and more about what did you do that an average receiver wouldn't, because that's how you measure how good a player is. Yeah, the Rams could have just signed someone off the streets who probably could have made this catch. You know, they could have found some sort of seventh rounder who could have made this catch and got open given the situation. What's impressive about Atwell is going to be what he does with this. Watch how he then turns the corner and he is going to pick up a good amount more yards. So that's why you draft him. It's not just for him to be able to make the grab. It's for him to then be able to do stuff and get more yards than the average player would. So there absolutely is value with Tutu Atwell. There certainly is. So it is still a bit of a surprising pick, I would say. You know, you had guys like Dyami Brown and Terrence Marshall who were still on the board, who I think most people felt like are better receivers than Atwell is. And in a vacuum, I do agree, but I also understand Atwell kind of fits that offense better, I think. And, you know, you look at it, I think a lot of what the Rams have done, they went out and got Van Jefferson, who was another kind of guy that just sort of might not be this elite guy, but should be pretty good and does fit the offense well. They also still have Cooper Kupp and Robert Woods. They also added DeSean Jackson, who is a huge question mark. That's basically just taking a flyer. So you have a kind of a crowded wide receiver room now. Kind of seems a bit curious to go out and get him, but at the same time, maybe he's the guy who could add the most value still. I mean, going wide receiver here does make some sense. And if we're just being honest, you take a random wide receiver selected in the second round, they have a better chance of being a Pro Bowler than taking the first wide receiver selected in that draft, because people, for whatever reason, are not good at drafting wide receivers. I don't know exactly what it is, but that is just a true fact. So the reality is I kind of always love getting a wide receiver in the second or third round, because there tends to be still pretty good receivers out there, and it makes sense to me. So yes, it's a bit like, okay, is that really what you want to do with your one second round, your first pick? Nick Bolton went right after. I think people thought they maybe could have gone linebacker, but I don't know. There's value there. I don't hate the pick, is I guess what I'll say. That's kind of what I think. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. What are your thoughts on the 2-2 Atwell selection? Always love hearing from you. And of course, as always, thanks for watching.